My name is Nahjee Grant. I'm a children's book author from Lower Merion. About 4 years now. I wanted to inspire young people to be the best they can be. And I've been writing short stories since I was in high school. And not professionally, obviously, but just writing short stories in my spare time. And I wanted to focus on primarily like kindergarten through second grade, trying to steal early values as early as possible in order for them to feel as though they can do anything that they want in their life, no matter what their circumstance, age, religion, background. So I want to start as early as possible. Yes, I get to travel. It's been a blessing. You know, we were working on our seventh book this year, so I've been blessed to be able to travel to a lot of different schools and a lot of different regions. And every school I travel to, the kids inspired me to keep writing. Whether it's the excitement that I get from them when I meet them, that they read my book and they are inspired to run for president, or they are inspired to be a doctor, or I see someone who looks like me in the book. And it just keeps me going. Very important. Very important. And that's one of the reasons why I started to write full-time. Because I understood that when I was younger, I didn't see a lot of people that looked like me in the books that I was reading when I was younger. And that followed all throughout elementary, middle school, and high school. And I said, well, what can I do to help curb that? So again, now today, when I get a text message from a parent, you know, after visiting a school, I connect with parents and teachers, and they say, well, he wants to run for office now because he sees, you know, someone who looks like him in the book. Not just because maybe President, you know, Obama, you know, for what he's done, but just also to be able to read a story and see someone who looks like them, do different things other than just maybe sports, you know. Again, I'm from Lower Merion, primarily in Ardmore, grew up in Ardmore, South Ardmore in Lower Merion, and went to Lower Merion School District, Penn Valley Elementary, Mouse Valley Middle School, Lower Merion High School. And for me, when I was I was a grade A student when I was in elementary school and in sixth grade. But by the time I got to seventh grade, I mean, it went from high to low. I mean, it went from A's to F's in 1 year, you know, to the point where, you know, I started failing classes. And, you know, I played basketball, you know, and I was very excited for that, but only played like 4 games because I was academically ineligible in seventh grade. And then I just barely made it in seventh grade. By the time I got to eighth grade, I didn't make the basketball team because my grades were already too bad in the first half of the school year. Right. So and I just scratched and clawed my way in the eighth grade, and I barely made it. And then I got a fresh start at Long Marion in high school, and fresh start school with a new school, but my lack of focus carried over into high school, and I pretty much fell off the grid academically in ninth grade as well, to where I failed ninth grade. I failed my freshman year. I explain that to every student, you know, with schools that I visit. And I got a second chance, because I guess I had like what do you call it back then, the No Child Left Behind Act. So they're like, hey, you can't be failing, right? You got all F's in here, but we'll give you a second chance. And there's a principal really who believed in me. I got a second chance, and because of that principal, I was able to graduate on time. But it made for a very difficult high school experience. So I had to play catch up all 3 years, 10th, 11th, and 12th. By the time I graduated high school, I was just ready to leave. I didn't have an interest in anything just to graduate. But then end of my senior year is when I heard that then Senator Barack Obama was going to be running for office. And it's because of Barack Obama that I got my life together. You know, I went from just trying to find my way, and I know, you know, what I wanted to do, to, okay, I need to put together a 5-year plan. This is what I want to do. And I was reading all of his books. He got involved in the community. So I said, you know, how can I get involved in the community? He was writing books. I was reading his books. I said, you know what? I had a somewhat of an interest in writing short stories when I was in 12th grade. So I said, you know, I'm going to write a book and put that on paper and really do it. And since 2008, 2009, I said I had a 5-6 year plan, and I followed that. And then here we are, to be able to write 7 books, you know, run my own business. I said I wanted to run for office, which was part of my 5-year plan back in 2009. In 2012, I actually got enough signatures, or attempted to get enough signatures to run in the 2012 election, because I wrote it down, so I knew I had to do it. I didn't win, but it showed a lot of people my commitment to achieve my goals. This year, I'll be running again in this year's election as well. I've been being a published author. Well, you know, for me, growing up, I always had an interest in biographies and autobiographies. Right. I can't say I had one particular book, or there was a writer or a mentor, but it was pretty much when I read his books and when I read Malcolm X's biography, when I read Muhammad Ali's, Martin Luther King's, just reading very interesting icons, you know, in American history, where I said, you know what, I want to, because my dad used to always say when I was reading these books, that, you know, you're going to be in one of these books one day, people are going to write about you one day, and I believed it. You know, so that's why I always had an interest in those type of books. I would read those books and be empowered to say, like, you know, I can do a lot of great things. First, what responsibility? Well, I think my responsibility is to tell my truth, right? Because my stories are based off of things that I've been through one way or another. So I'm just telling my truth to the readers. I think that's my responsibility to the kids that I want to reach. To be a reader, well, you can't, you know, you don't want to say one thing to a kid to say, yeah, you should read, and then you're not reading. It doesn't really make much sense. So yeah, I think obviously every writer should be reading. I mean, more importantly, or as important, every writer, you know, should just keep pursuing their, you know, their writing as important. But yeah, I think every writer should be reading, of course. Well, I've heard other authors say that like they do not read a lot of other authors' work, and they kind of stick focused to their own, or maybe someone's in a similar genre. But everyone's different, you know. I grew up in a library. You know, my aunt was a librarian for 30 years, so I grew up in a library. So for me, reading was very important. I had no choice. Yeah, that's a really good question. I think first and foremost, should be taken seriously, like for what they know. You know, it'd be harder for a writer to be taken seriously if I write a cookbook. I'm not a very good cook. So I don't know how much I'd be taken seriously to write a cookbook or a book on parenting when I'm not a parent. You know. But I have been through, I know my struggles, you know, academically, I know my struggles in order to publish my books. You know, I know my struggle to be taken seriously as a writer from my first book to my seventh. So I can write about those things, right? Because they're, like, again, like I said, that's my truth, right? So, but I also think that if you do your research, you know, you have an interest in other things, in other areas, that you can take it seriously as long as you know the topic, right? So if I took cooking classes, right? If I learned from other people who've written cookbooks and I put together one myself, then that's one thing. But I would say, you know what? That's a big market for cookbooks, and I just write one. I don't think take it seriously. I think that you should just, you know, write what you know.
Slaughter, the Executive Director of Literacy University. Real Education TV. We will tackle sensitive issues plaguing public education. This groundbreaking show celebrates real learning, real education, teachers in the trenches, and real results. Our viewers will be riveted by our discussions with administrators and students in the middle, making decisions. By tackling sensitive subjects, we will eat the elephant in the room one bite at a time. Red, Real Education TV.
Enter the zone. coming to the beginning of, to the end of 2016, we've written and published 6 books. We'll have the 7th book finally published and launched at the Barnes & Noble's in Vroomov, which took 6 years in order to get to that milestone. And then my goal has always been to do 2 books a year. You know, so we're trying to figure out what we're going to do for the fall, winter. But for now, we're going to focus on that book to come out. Well, again, when I mentioned that 5-year plan, what I was trying to do was find a temporary job that I could use in order to fund my goal, right, and fund those life goals. And I found one that was right around the corner from me. Actually, it was a 24/7 gym, right? And I worked overnight, sweeping and mopping floors for 6 years. I had jobs here and there, but when I found that one, it was like I was there consistently, where I need those other ones. And I would write at night, because I was there from 10 o'clock at night to 6 o'clock in the morning. So while I was there, I would write, and I just ended up just turning out one book after another. And I started to go to do book signings, go to churches and libraries and local bookstores. But I said there's a larger goal, right? And at the time, it was either Borders or Barnes & Noble. So late 2016, I said, I'm going to have a book event in Barnes & Noble's in 2017, period. Like, that's just a goal of mine. I wrote it down on a piece of paper, so now it has to come true because I wrote it down, right? It's the goal. We're in 2017, and we're going to have a book signing at Barnes & Noble. But it took a very long time. Like I said, it took 6 years. There were a lot of people who said that I couldn't do it. There are people who, when I would show them my books, and they would say, you know, these aren't very good. The messages, you know, kids won't relate to these type of images or these type of messages. You should focus on this rather than this. But then when I would ask them, you know, so where's your book or at, you know, what are you doing? And then I would hear nothing. That's how I knew that I was on the right path, because they were trying to deter me because they weren't doing what they wanted to be doing. I didn't listen to anyone who said that I couldn't do it over those 6 years. And I'm just glad that we can have this book signing and book event at the Barnes & Noble. Well, first, it depends on the source, because I'm a good listener. Like, whether you're coming from, you know, whether I can't understand if it's hate or constructive criticism unless I actually hear you. So I'll listen to you, and I go, okay, I can tell this person's coming from, you know, from a hateful point of view, as opposed to, okay, they actually understand what I'm going through, and they have a point that they want to make to help me be better. But I assess everything the same. So I just take it in information, and I go, okay, this person really cares about me, because I see the person show up, right? They give me pointers, they're texting me, they call me, hey, I seen your show, hey, I read your book, hey, I just bought it on Amazon. That's how I know it's coming from a constructive criticism standpoint, as opposed to, where do you come from? It's out of nowhere, and you just pointing fingers. You know, so, but I take constructivism very well. Helps me be a better person, but it all depends on the source. That's a very good question. Yes and no. Yes and no. Not in particular, like with the stories, with my books, right? Like, I know where I want to go with the books that I've written and the books that I want to write. For example, I know I have a couple books that are related towards one of the characters going to the White House and meeting President Obama, right? And then gets inspired to run for office himself as a young black boy, right? You can't have a story about going to the White House now and having... The story is different. The story is a little different. But what I do tell the kids and students that I get to share my story and my books with is, if you look for the positive in anything, you'll find it. So everything that's going on politically, right, and maybe even economically, like, you know, these past couple of weeks, one thing that I do share with the students is, no matter how you look at it, that there were a lot of people who thought that the current president was not going to win, right? And the narrative was that he was going to lose, and there were a lot of people against him in order to win, but still won. Now you have an argument about, you know, a grown folk argument about how, you know, the process of winning, but it's still, that person is still in the office. So what I do share with them is that no matter, which leans into what I've been saying to them all along, and it's further cements what I say to them all the time, is don't listen to people. So I share that message with them, saying, like, look, no matter what anyone's saying to you, you just keep going. And more times than not, that, you know, whatever goal you have, it'll happen. Don't listen to any of the negative noise, unless anyone's saying you can do it. So again, I don't put those into the story, but I do just share those type of, I share this message that are in the story and try to relate that to what's going on in the world. I guess my best book hasn't been written yet, right? It's because, you know, you gotta keep going. But, you know, the last book that I did, that I've written and published in 2016, I tried to write that story for everyone, not just focus on K through 2, K through 3, but a book that's written for everyone. That was a short story about my personal story that I shared with you earlier. And I tried to say, well, if you're in kindergarten or if you're in 12th grade, you can read this book and get something from it. I want to go further with that, and that will be for primarily for high school leading into college. For me, once I realized what I wanted to do with my life and how I wanted to get there, for me, I went to the extreme. I cut off everything that did not pertain to my goal. I was already the type of person that didn't, you know, party, or drink, or smoke. Even prior to, like, me trying to figure out what I wanted to do, I was never really into those things anyway. But I tripled down on it once I knew. So, like, my blueprint was to stay focused, and anything that didn't pertain to my goal or to making my life better, I didn't focus on it. I didn't listen to any negative noise or any negative, or stayed away from anyone who tried to bring any negativity into my life. I would just randomly knock on people's door knock on the schools, you know, door, hey, I wrote my first book, how can I talk to students? And I'm like, who are you? Hey, now you know, after having this conversation. I would go to networking events, but not just to meet anybody. If I knew there was someone specific that I wanted to meet, and that's how I wanted to talk with them, then I would do that. So again, I would stay focused, and I would know, I put together a plan, who I wanted to talk to, who I wanted to meet, where I wanted to be, and I just focused on that alone and nothing else. Very good question, you know, because I think it's a very good question, because one, I was never big on social media as far as using it. You know, the conversation that my mom had one day, she was like, you're gonna have to use it in order to reach people. That was a couple of years, that was like 2 years ago, and I mean, it's big for me. Like I said, I just have a Facebook business page, and I try to just focus on one social media platform, so I'm trying to be everywhere. Which some people are, and that's perfectly fine, whether it's Instagram for pictures or you know, with Snapchat or Twitter, like whatever. But for me, I just focus on my Facebook business page, and it's been very helpful as far as getting the message out and connecting with new people, tagging other businesses. If they don't know me, I'm like, oh, well, I'm tagging them, they don't know me now, you know, to try and reach new audiences. As far as advertising on my Facebook business page and you know, for $20 reaching 20,000 people. I mean, I don't know where else you can do that, whether radio or television. So it's been very important for me, and it's been important for my business as well. Having said that, you can find me on Facebook. You just type in my name, Nahjee, 2 E's, last name Grant. Come right, my Facebook business page will come right up. My website, which has links to my books, which are on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Walmart, eBay, at nahjeegrant.com. And on there, you can also email me. Anyone can almost email me anytime if anyone has any questions about writing. I get a lot of questions when I go to book fairs and book signings, people who are aspiring writers, and they always want to know how I do certain things. At nahjee.grant@gmail.com.
Indicator, enough said on that. Yo, what's up? You know what it is. It's your man, the Indicator. Holla.
Tune in, man.